Have you ever heard someone say they are busy as a bee? People use this simile because bees are very hard workers. Bees have many different jobs in their lifetime, and they do some pretty amazing things. When you think of a bee, you probably picture a small buzzing bug with black and yellow stripes. You're most likely imagining the honeybee, but there are over 20,000 different kinds of bees in the world. While most bees have different patterns of black and yellow, some bees, like the metallic sweat bee, are green. The small carpenter bee is a bright turquoise. Honeybees are insects, and like other insects, their bodies have three main parts: the head, the thorax, and the abdomen. A bee has two antennae on top of its head and six legs. Female honeybees have stingers, and some of them sting. Males do not have stingers at all. Honeybees live with lots of other bees in a group called a colony. Bee colonies usually live together in a hive. Hives can be built inside trees, fallen logs, caves, or even large rocks. You may have even seen a beehive on the corner of a building. Though bees in the wild build their own hives, they can also live in man-made hives that are taken care of by beekeepers. Beekeepers make sure that colonies of bees are healthy and continue to grow. They also collect honey from the bees. Beekeepers wear special suits that cover their whole bodies to make sure that they don't get stung, but they are very gentle with the bees and take good care of them. Honeybees live in nests, or hives, with tens of thousands of other bees. These bees all work together to make sure that the hive is clean and protected, and that the babies and queens are fed and healthy. Each bee has a different job that helps take care of the colony. Every colony has one female queen bee. The queen honeybee's job is to lay eggs to help the colony grow. There are also drone bees, which are all males. A drone's job is to help the queen make eggs. The rest of the colony is made up of worker bees, and they are the busiest bees of all. All worker honeybees are female, and throughout their lives, they do different jobs to help the colony. The first job a worker bee has is cleaning. The bee cleans the cell it was hatched in and makes that cell ready either for another egg or for honey. A second job for the bee is to nurse the baby honeybees. The worker bee helps take care of the baby bees by bringing them food to eat. Honeybees eat nectar, a sweet liquid that comes from a flower. They also eat pollen, which is a powdery substance that also comes from a flower, and honey. You may know all about pollen, as it can make you sneeze. The next job a honeybee has is that of building. The bees help build the hive using beeswax, which the bees make themselves. This keeps the hive strong and growing. The honeybee may also have the job of guarding. When on guard, the bee protects the hive from dangers like hungry animals, bees from a different colony, and even humans. A worker honeybee rarely leaves the hive, but when it does, it is to go out and find food. Foraging bees search for pollen and nectar. Both of these are found in flowers. The honeybee collects nectar from a flower with her straw-like tongue, sucking it up and storing it in her honey stomach. She also collects pollen with her body. The pollen sticks to her legs, back, and body. When she lands on another flower, this pollen falls, helping the plants to reproduce. When the honeybee's tummy is full of nectar, she goes back to the hive, where other worker bees help her to turn it into honey. And then, where do you think they put it? In the beeswax cells, maybe the same ones they made earlier in their lives. Do you know what shape this is? It's a hexagon, a shape with six sides. Hives are made up of tiny hexagonal cells made of beeswax. Bee eggs are laid in these cells, where they will hatch into baby bees. Honey is also made in the cells of a beehive. The honeybee works hard its entire life to create honey. How many bees do you think worked to make this little teaspoon of honey? 12 bees worked their entire lives, and this is how much honey they made. Can you imagine how many honeybees would have to work together to make an entire jar of honey?
Find out why over 1 million parents have used goodandbeautifulbooklist.com to find clean, appropriate books. Check out the free book list now and dive into the world of good and beautiful literature.